the bell icon to turn on notifications.
In this video, we'll get an overview of roadmaps in Jira. All right, so let's come into our project here and come up to roadmap, and we're going to see an error. So the reason for this is because, if you recall, we are in the marketing team project here, but when we set up our board in the marketing team project, we're actually pulling in issues from a different project. So that's the first thing to know about roadmaps, is they only work in the same project where your issues live. Okay, so let's hop over to where our issues actually live in this Jira installation, which is mostly in this sample project where we had Jira generate a bunch of those issues. So now if we come into our roadmap, we can see the actual roadmap here. It's pretty empty. Let's create an epic. So let's say that epic will be to complete the Jira course. Maybe another one to actually take what you've learned and implement new Jira skills. So you can see as I'm creating those epics, then Jira is assigning numbers to them, which basically it's actually creating those issues. And we can come in here and we can add in child issues. So if you remember the hierarchy that we learned about earlier in an earlier video, where we learned about epics and user stories, or really any other issue type, there's different issue types we could create here. But those are going to live under the epics. So we can say maybe finish section one, section two, section three, you get the idea. We can add some under this as well. Maybe something like, you know, decide if company managed or team managed projects are right for us. You know, you can make that decision, or maybe kind of what we were looking at in the last video, review the data in our org's reports to see what we need to track, whatever sort of issues that you want to have under those epics. And then what happens here in the roadmap is we can start to track some of that. So you can see we already have a sprint on here. So this was a sprint that we created earlier in this course. And we could say, you know what, this one here, let's drop that into that sprint. So right now, Jira is going to say, oh, you know what? That scope has now been changed because this sprint is actually active. And so what we learned earlier with sprints is in your sprint planning meeting, you're going to decide how much work gets done or what work gets done in that sprint. So say this sprint is 2 weeks long. What work are we going to get done in the next 2 weeks? And then throughout that 2 weeks, ideally, you're not going to add anything else to that because you've already decided how much work is going to get done. So if you do that in an active sprint, then Jira is going to give you a notification and say, hey, the scope is changing. So you should probably go in and remove something else. That way you're not trying to get 3 or 4 weeks worth of work done in 2 weeks. That's just setting yourself and your team up for failure. But you'll notice here, because we are working with sprints and we're working with Scrum, I can't add issues anywhere else. The reason for that is because we can only add things into sprints. We don't have any other sprints. So let's come in here and let's create a new sprint real quick. Doesn't have to be active, but we could add in a future one. Let's say we're going to start this one on the 30th and then have it be 2 weeks. Let's update that. So now if we come into our roadmap, we'll see that on our roadmap. So now we can say, okay, well, we finished section one in this, finished section two in this one here, maybe section three as well. You can start to see how we can start to organize these things in the future. And that's really where the roadmaps are helpful, is not only, well, not only the future, as you're doing this, of course, you're going to be able to see things, you know, as they're completed. But you really get a kind of a different visual sense for what is getting completed and where. And then on the epic itself, you can see the issues in there. You can hop to those. You know, you can, just like any other issue, you know, have your comments, have being able to interact with your team to see how things are going. You can start to see, you know, maybe this one is in progress. So you can start to see the progress for the overall epic, right? So we can see that you know, as this one's done, okay, now one out of three, it's 33% done. So we can start to see the overall progress on our bigger projects. You remember, epics are bigger projects, and the roadmap is really a great way to be able to visualize those and the work being done. Now, I do want to point out, if you are using Jira Software Premium, as we learned earlier in this course, there is a more advanced version of roadmaps, but that is an additional cost. And again, as I mentioned, I am not using Premium in this course. I'm using Jira Software. Okay, great. I would encourage you to take some time to play around with roadmaps and get an idea for how your organization can use them. And when you're ready, I'll see you in the next video, where we'll look at how we can create issues in bulk. See you there.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.